Hello, this is Bern, and on today's video, I'm going to share with you 7 signs that the guy you want is emotionally unavailable. Hello, this is Bern. Welcome to another edition of BernMendez.com, a space where I share with ambitious, conscious, heart-centered, and successful women how you can attract the man and the relationship you want without the need for gimmicks, manipulation, or crazy techniques. Now, the first thing I want to get out of my chest right now is that a lot of women feel that they are having a problem in life because they're attracting emotionally unavailable men. Attracting men comes in different shapes and forms, and it's really hard if you have a strong magnet to only attract good men, to only attract emotionally available men. So that's not the problem. The problem is you attaching to, investing your time with, or wasting your time with emotionally unavailable men. If they are attracted to you, but you say, well, thank you, but no thanks, it's not a problem. If they're attracted to you and you invest your time without knowing what to look out for, then that becomes a problem. Second thing I want to get off my chest is sometimes this happens when you connect with a guy that you feel strong chemistry with, and instead of taking the time to get to know him properly, to develop friendship, and then figure out if that relationship is possible, you go from 0 to 60 miles an hour really quickly because you don't want to miss out on this great opportunity. You tell yourself that he's the guy you've been waiting for, and then later, when his testosterone levels are not as high and his hormones are not shining as powerfully, you get the feeling that you got a lemon. And then it might be too late because you feel too attached to him. Here's the first sign. He doesn't like to plan things with you. You connect with a guy, and every now and then you'll connect with guys who are more spontaneous than others, nothing wrong with that, but when the guy never can plan things with you, has a hard time figuring out when to go on vacation, when to do things, when to stop doing other things for you, that's when you start noticing that there might be something in the background that lets you know he's not available. Second one is he doesn't make a priority in his life. He has other things that are important for him, and when he has time, when he doesn't have other things going on, then he can see you. When he doesn't get inconvenienced in some way, then he's available to see you. But when he has to, I mean, I'm not saying that you have to be his only priority in life, but when you're not a priority in his life, that's a good sign that he's not emotionally available, not just to you, to a relationship. Third, he doesn't talk about his emotions with you. He doesn't talk about his past, he doesn't talk about his present, doesn't talk about his future, doesn't talk about what he's feeling, what he's needing. That's partially what emotionally available means, not being willing to express emotion, not being willing to share with vulnerability, with courage, what you're experiencing to the person who's doing that with you. And this becomes especially painful if you are expressing your emotions, if you're someone who wants to share things and he's not. I mean, most guys will probably want to share less than most women, but when he wants to share nothing, that's when you start noticing, okay, this guy is not open to something deep. Because a relationship that doesn't have that component of being able to talk about things that matter to you, that's empty. There's no need for that in your life unless you want to settle for something that's lower than what your potential is. Fourth, he doesn't dive or go deeper into your emotions. Not only does he not like to talk about important things, deep things, about his own personality and feelings, but he doesn't really care to know you that way. He cares to talk about superficial things, but when it comes to what you feel, what you're excited about, what your dreams are, what you're experiencing in life, how things are going, he doesn't want to go there. Or he wants to, but doesn't have the capacity to go there, which ends up being the same. He doesn't do it. And then you start feeling not seen, not heard, not understood, not only because you can't read him, but because he doesn't want to read you as well. Okay? Number five, he does not involve you in his close circles, his families. His family members, his friends, people he cares about, those are kept at bay. He has a separate life with them and then a separate life with you. And you get the feeling that there's a specific reason why it's not happening. Maybe he doesn't feel compelled to connect with you in case you don't work out. Maybe he doesn't want to tell anyone that he's seeing you. He doesn't feel super proud of seeing you. Maybe he just doesn't want to create something deep and intimate. That's a deep characteristic of someone who is not emotionally available. He doesn't want to create something that creates that feeling of responsibility later on. Number six, he gets very avoidant or defensive when you talk about anything regarding your future with him. When you ask questions regarding the future, he might get uncomfortable. Many guys will get uncomfortable. Many guys will not feel great about that talk. But when he gets uncomfortable and he can't talk about the future, he doesn't enjoy talking about your future with him. He can't envision something, and you feel like you're the one who's really working hard in the relationship. You have the vision, you have the goal, you have the idea of what this could be, and he seems to not care about it, not share with you what it is, and not express it, then again, one more sign that the guy is not open to the kind of depth that you're seeking. Last one, which might seem obvious, but it's not sometimes so obvious. He's logistically unavailable. You want to do things, he's busy. You want to, like, he has a tennis match and he has his poker night with friends and he has his work with, but he's not available to do things that matter. More times than not, he can't do things with you because he doesn't have the time. When you don't have the time constantly, it means you don't have the intention, the intensity and the clarity. Why? Because when you have something important, you find the time for it. Does that make sense? Now, last thing I want to share in terms of if you connect with a guy who has the 7 characteristics, there's a couple of things that can happen. One is you can move on and connect with someone who is open. You can have a conversation and see how open he is to changing these things. But the thing you don't want to do is to turn this man into your project. If this is a guy who's not in a space in his life where he craves this type of relationship, or he craves it but can't deliver it, the last thing you want to do is convert into his mommy or his therapist. You want to make sure that you can get what you want, and if it's not with him, that you can move on and create the intensity you want without having to go through kindergarten every single month with this dude. Hope this is helpful, useful, and insightful. And if it is, and you'd like to enter a fulfilling relationship in a fraction of the time, then on the first link on the description of this video, you're going to find a class that I created for you, a training. All you have to do is click on the first link, enter your name and email, and you'll be immediately redirected to this free training. Now, if you like this video, click like or thumbs up and subscribe to my channel so you can be notified of new episodes as they come out. Last but not least, if you've been at this thing, and this thing meaning you want to find love and it's hard, you've been watching my videos, somebody else's videos, you've been reading books, you've been going through therapy even, and it's not happening, you might need a different kind of help. If you'd like to find out if I can help you, hold you by the hand, as I've done hundreds of times with women all around the world, to get into the relationship you want with a lot less anxiety and a lot less pain and a lot more fun, then second link on the description will allow you to apply to work with me. And if we're a fit, we can work together to create this in a fraction of the time. Thank you so much for connecting with me. And as always, I challenge you to live a full and a conscious life.